We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday.
Welcome to this new episode of NTB Dialogues, a special CNS series presenting insightful and thought-provoking interviews with leaders to accelerate progress towards ending TB. This series underpins the urgency to step up the fight against this epidemic. And this interview today, this episode, is the first in the new year 2020, where we can just renew our resolve to end tuberculosis by 2030. Now, Thailand is among the 193 countries that have promised to end TB by 2030 as part of the Sustainable Development Goals. And we have just, in fact, even less than 132 months to do so. Now, today's special episode of NTB Dialogues features two special guests. I have with me Ms. Natiprada Nethirath,
yes,
or whom we lovingly call Poo.
Yes, thank you.
And Mrs. GRI Kantipong Se. Both are medical technologists at the Office of Disease Prevention and Control, Ministry of Public Health, Thailand. Welcome, Gia and Poo.
Thank you.
And thanks for finding time to speak with us. And you know, I was very intrigued by the name of your office, Disease Prevention and
yes.
Control. Very often we forget about prevention. We just talk about disease control. But as medical technologists, you know how important prevention is. It's equally important as control. So we don't only have to treat a disease, but we have to prevent it if we want to end. So can you please tell us more about this laboratory where we are sitting here just right now in the meeting room of the lab? What are the facilities which are available here, and how is it helping in TB care and control in Thailand?
About the history?
Yes, yes. History.
We are the called region one of Thailand. Region one is control about eight province in northern part of Thailand.
Okay.
Yes. Eight province is about 90 hospital, 90 government hospital. Yes. And we control about the infectious disease. The mainly is TB. Yes, because very important of infectious disease. Yes, and a lot of patients in northern of Thailand because very near other country, just as Myanmar like this, or migrant, then a lot of patients in this region.
So how many such other labs are there in Thailand? This is one lab which is controlling eight provinces of the northern region. How many other such labs are there?
13 regions in Thailand.
13 regions?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So there are 13 such labs, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Almost same.
Okay. Okay. So what are the facilities, what are the testings and all? Could we just explain in a little bit detail which are being done here in this lab?
About the facility?
Yes.
Facility about the gold standard test is the culture and duct sensitivity test. We have the facility to support to working the special lab, especially is biosafety cabinet, such as biosafety cabinet or negative pressure room. We are planning to build the negative pressure loop in this year. This year is 2020. In this year, planning to build the negative pressure loop for culture and for leveling laboratory of infectious disease in the future.
Okay, can you explain to our listeners what is actually a negative pressure room and how will it be better? How will it improve culture?
More better. More better than the common room or double door room, because the negative pressure room, the
we can control the air.
Yes.
Inside, outside.
Okay.
Mm. Air inside cannot flow out okay. to the environment.
Okay.
If one if air flowing out have the HEPA to like a filtering the air inside before spread to environment.
So do other labs in Thailand have the negative pressure room? The other labs which are there in Thailand?
In Thailand?
In the Faculty of Medicine and the big hospital in the province.
They have.
They have.
Okay. Why, what is Thailand doing to ensure quality diagnosis, timely diagnosis of TB? And what is the process flow like? If a patient comes for has TB symptoms, what happens first? Means what is the flow process?
The process if the patient have symptom same TB such as cough, go to the hospital near the house inside house. Go to the hospital and the hospital will screen by nurse first. Clean if cough and another symptom same TB, patient must chest X-ray.
Okay, first is chest X-ray.
Chest X-ray is okay. the important. Mm-hmm. The first choice is chest X-ray and collect sputum to screening by microscopic AB screening. Yes.
And then, so the sample is taken for microscopy.
Mm-hmm.
And then microscopy is done.
If they positive,
yes.
we will culture.
Okay. If yes. it is positive, then you will do culture.
Culture at the hospital site.
Okay.
Yes. And if negative, AB negative, but chest X-ray is same TB. Chest X-ray same TB. 50%, 50-50% like this. Chest X-ray same TB. We have the new machine called it expert.
Okay, gene expert.
Gene expert to test. Yes, this is the molecular test for DNA of TB. Very high sensitivity. If positive by gene expert, patient doctor must take the medicine for the patient.
Okay, so only those which are the microscopy says it is negative, only those samples are sent to gene expert and not the positive ones?
The main point is chest X-ray.
Main point is chest X-ray, yes.
Yes. yes.
Then second step is microscopy.
Mm-hmm.
Now if it gives negative,
if negative but chest X-ray same, still treat patient.
Yes, you treat the patient. But when do you take the sample to gene expert? When does it go to gene expert? All samples will not go to gene expert.
The gene expert use the chest X-ray is the main point. If chest X-ray abnormal, ship to test to gene expert. Because gene expert is very high sensitivity. And another choice is if the patient is the high risk population patient and chest X-ray same TB, collect sample to test by expert.
Okay. And what are the high risk populations?
What is the high population? Such as elder, diabetes, HIV, prisoner, household contact, like this, or migrant. Yes.
Okay, so these are the high risk population.
Unneed in high population. Yes.
Do you think universal drug susceptibility test is important?
Yes, universal drug susceptibility test really important nowadays because the goal of Thailand is 1-0 TB. Then goal is one, all of new patients has the test universal DST test.
Hmm.
What?
So when will, when do you think Thailand will have universal DST for all testing, or are they moving towards it? Is the country moving towards universal DST?
Just as expert is one of test of
yes.
Then if we scan screening by skin expert first, because nowadays in Thailand have 110 machine of gene expert all of the country. Then enough to screening to check, and this is the one of universal DST.
Yes.
And another universal DST, just as conventional duct sensitivity test, and or other method of molecular test, such as lipoassay or real-time PCR.
Yes, okay. What about latent TB? Because now there are targets for, I think, putting 30 million people globally for the prevention of TB, that is latent TB, prevention of TB by 2022. That is the target. So what is happening in Thailand about latent TB? Are they being tested for latent TB and putting on treatment?
You mean latent TB?
Yes,
right?
Latent TB. Yes.
Now the latent TB is the big project in Thailand.
Okay.
The center of government TB center in the Bangkok have this project. It's very important. We use the test for new worker in hospital, or the young people less than 18 years old.
Okay.
The screening, and if positive latent TB, the patient must take the medicine. Yes.
What is the test for latent TB here? What is it, the skin test? What test are they doing for latent TB?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
But another, a very high sensitivity, but about the screening test, if not latent TB.
Okay. In the latest global WHO global TB report, it is said that there are 5 high risk factors of TB. In Thailand, it is the order is malnutrition, then alcohol, smoking, HIV and diabetes.
Yes.
In fact, in all countries, these are the 5 high risk factors. So is anything special being done in Thailand to take care of this? How to control these risk factors for TB, like diabetes, alcohol, smoking?
This is called a high key population.
My grandma.
Just as elder. Elder or almost is HIV is very important. Diabetes
is diabetes. Yes.
Staff in the hospital is risk too.
Yes, staff in the hospital is at risk too. So what is being done for that? Do you all take precautions? Do they take precautions to
annual check up. Chest X-ray.
Okay.
And we must do the universal precaution.
Yes.
Universal precaution. Okay. What about Gia? We read in one of your research papers about suboptimal amount of medicine in the blood for a TB patient who is undertaking treatment. How does it affect the cure rate, or does it affect the cure rate at all? Like if you are giving the right amount of medicine, but there is less medicine in the blood.
Yes.
So what is the result of that? What happens in that case? The patient doesn't get cured, or what happens?
Again, please.
Yes. Yes, yes. About your research paper, you did that research. I think it was many years ago, but you measured the amount of medicine in the patient's blood, TB patient's blood, and it was less than what was required. It was very little less, suboptimal.
But level is lower?
Lower, yes, level is lower.
There is many factors such as the metabolism.
Okay.
The absorption when they eat. Yes, and pharmacokinetic, pharmacodynamic.
So then what happens in those cases if the drug level is less? The patient will not get cured, or what will happen? Because
they will, if they are not cured, they will have the resistance.
Okay, they'll develop resistance. Okay. So are there many such patients, or some of them only? Does this happen in many TB patients or few patients? Just only some of them have this less amount of medicine?
Someone have some patient not good. Didn't take medicine every day.
Okay. Once a patient is diagnosed with tuberculosis or drug resistant TB, then what is the next step? Then they get their medicine from a government center, or what happens?
The patient must take medicine every day. We have the staff to take care,
to
look after how to the house of the patient, just as take medicine in front of the staff.
Okay.
Yes, every day. Yes.
So every day they have to go to the dot center and take the medicine there?
Yes, yes.
Every day they have to go.
Yes.
Okay.
Or if very far, every far cannot go to hospital every day, cannot, we use mobile phone.
Okay.
To video call, like this.
Or their cousin.
Yes.
In the house
and take medicine with video call.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
So they have to
to the nurse,
eat the medicine in front of the video, and the nurse knows
every
that.
day.
Okay.
With the nurse or the hospital staff look after them.
Okay. And what about in drug resistant tuberculosis? What treatment is followed for drug resistant tuberculosis?
Treatment,
still giving the injections, or you are
if the first line drug no injection, we use only take
tablet
medicine. And if no resistant TB, the sputum must convert to negative in 2 months after take medicine. If on treatment 3 months still have AB positive, that means one may be no take medicine, or two may be resistant TB. Two choice. Then we must test about DST again in the 3rd month of
treatment.
And
then what is the treatment for drug resistant TB? That is for how many months?
How many months of takes medicine?
For drug resistant.
Six.
Drug resistant TB.
Drug resistant TB.
Second line.
Conventional period is 12.
Second line
TB, resistant TB, 20 months.
20 months.
But new WHO endorsed the shorter regimen, shorter course, about nine.
So is Thailand using the 9 month treatment now?
Yes, must the checklist for include or exclude patient. Include checklist, just as healthy, strong.
Okay.
No kidney disease, no liver,
okay.
Like this.
Then
no pigment.
Okay. Then you give the 9-month treatment.
Yes.
Okay.
But must test the sensory test before use shorter course.
Okay. Anything else you would like to share, which I might have missed out? Anything else you would like to say, Chia?
You like to say? anything?
Our staff, many person in our department go to see your department at India.
Okay.
And I hope to see some.
Yes,
someday.
Of course. Yes, please do. We will look forward to that.
To exchange?
Yes, to exchange. Yes. One last question. We want your message for the World TB Day 2020, World Tuberculosis Day. We celebrate the World commemorate the World Tuberculosis Day. What is your message? And especially the message for women, because.
For women. Why?
Yeah, because we are all women here, and women are an important part of the workforce. And in many parts of the world, women are still not seeking. They do not have health-seeking behavior. In many countries, women are the last ones to go to a hospital to get checked. How are things in Thailand? We want to know. And what is the message for the women?
About in Thailand. We want to see TB, and we plan to use the chest X-ray is the point, both of men or women, both. But in the women, I think gender not different, yes. But the government want to cover prevent and protect all of gender, yes. Especially elder, yes, or close contact. Then we want to use chest X-ray is the most important, and use new technology such as molecular test, and up to the sequencing is the gold standard test of molecular, top of molecular. To prevent and protect all of citizens in Thailand. And now the latent TB is very important, because if important in the care worker in hospital, work care, because we are the staff in the hospital.
Yes.
A lot of patient and very highly scoop. And latent TB is the very important nowadays. And in the future, maybe latent TB method sent to the region. And new technology is want to screening and finding very early TB in Thai citizen, including migrant, including male or female.
Gia, what is your message?
Use the new technology, update knowledge every day to practice every day to finding earlier pattern.
Are there any questions you have from the audience?
About the lung cancer, probably you can ask.
Yes, please. What has been asked?
Yeah. So about the TB and lung cancer. So do you get cases here where a person with TB is who come for test may not have TB but may have lung cancer because symptoms same, right?
Symptoms same.
Is it happening here in India? It happens a lot. TB and lung cancer symptoms same. So people think maybe they have TB, but actually they have lung cancer. Is it happening here?
Yeah. Yes. Just as FB or microscopic, TB positive and TB negative FB, 50-50%, right? Very, very low sensitivity. 50-50% fouling. Then about the same symptom is very important. Then we must use new technology such as molecular test. Important to use point of care. Cannot use only symptom, cannot use only chest X-ray, or FB is very good but low sensitivity. Patient who go to hospital is the maybe severe case, severe case of blooding caused like this. Then latent TB or no symptom TB, don't go to hospital. Then the government has the project use mobile X-ray where mobile X-ray bus to reach to house site and everyone in the village or high risk population can use the X-ray for mobile very easily. Then this is called passive finding. Active finding is mean work pattern continuous, yes,
okay.
Is very less to far. But now, after use the passive finding, we found a lot of patients.
Yes. Lot more patients.
Yes.
Okay.
Then if chest is laid at the wall, keep the collect the sputum and test at the hospital laboratory.
Collect the sputum from the home?
Yes, yes. Or the hospital laboratory in the Thailand almost have the gene expert already.
That's good. Taking the diagnosis to the
patient.
Yes,
very easily and can find a lot of patients nowadays.
Thank you very much, Jia and Poo. Friends, today we were in conversation with Mrs. Jia Ranai, Kanti Pongse, and Ms. Natiprada Netirath, medical technologist at the Office of Disease Prevention and Control, Ministry of Public Health, Thailand, at this CNS special series of NTB Dialogues, which features thought-provoking and insightful interviews with leaders. Both our leaders were women today, so all force to women. Thank you very much.
Thank you.